Fashion Academy for male and female. Plenty, plenty style for different garments. Anywhere you dey, no be wahala. Make you call our number. We dey teach people how to be a fashion designer. Designer Ankara bag we dey do. Ankara shoes.
Hello guys, welcome back to See Fashion Academy. Today I'll be doing a very great topic. This topic is not that common, but it's very, very important. Today I'll be solving so many of the problems that we usually encounter in our day-to-day activities as what fashion designers or as tailors. Some of those problems are, example, drafting a perfect armhole pattern, drafting a perfect sleeve pattern, fixing of sleeve on armhole, fixing of zip, shirt hemming, that is hemming the damn part of the shirt, either single hemming or double hemming. Now, hemming with what? Bias. Hemming with what? Same fabric. Like, especially, let's say you want to make use of bias and you don't want to make use of the artificial bias, the one they usually make and sell, and you want to use your material to make a bias. I will teach you how to do that. Okay, now I'm also going to teach you how to fix an elastic. Like, example, when you want to make a balloon sleeve and the rest, you know, I'll also make sure I teach you how to do that. So, and so many things, Sha, I'll be treating it in this particular channel today. Okay, so please, but before we start, I want you to do something for me. Make sure you click on that subscribe button, because the more you click, the more others get to see this video. And please, 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 don't fail to do what? Click on that thumbs up. Make sure you click on that thumbs up. Click on that like button. That is the only way you support us. The more you click, the more you keep receiving our videos. Thank you very much, and may God bless you. So firstly, we're starting with the armhole pattern. So I'm going to teach you guys how to perfectly draft your armhole pattern. Okay, so as you can see, now look at this particular one you're seeing here. This is actually, now look at it very well. This is like a normal top bodice. Are you seeing it? So this is my what? Bust line. This is my under bust line. And this is my what? Half length. That is also what? Waistline. Okay, I've not yet marked out the what? Shoulder. So I'm going to do that now. Because before you construct your armhole, you are going to what? Mark out the what? Shoulder. So let's start. The shoulder in this case is what? 14 inches. You are going to divide 14 inches by 2, which is going to give you what? 7 inches. Okay. Okay, look at it. It's going to give you what? 7 inches. So mark out that 7 inches and make sure you add extra what? Half inch to it. Are you seeing it? Make sure you add extra half inch to it. Please do the same thing down here. Are you saying it's 7 inches and extra what? Half inch to it. The reason why we are doing this thing is so that's to get what? A straight line. Why make use of our rule? Okay, now look at it very well. Why am I marking this straight line? This straight line is for both what? The shoulder slope and the what? The armhole length. Okay, now before you draft your what? Armhole, what you are going to do is what? You are going to slant your shoulder. We also call it what? Shoulder slope. This shoulder slope is done so as to make sure that your dress relaxes very well at the what? Shoulder. This is because none of us, that even you that is listening to this, your shoulder isn't straight. Do you understand? So because your shoulder isn't straight, your shoulder is not going to be straight on the fabric also. It's going to be also be what? Slanted. Do you understand? So that is what we call a shoulder slope. So for female, in order to get this shoulder slope, take your tape, place it from here. Are you seeing it? After marking out the shoulder and the other ones, take your tape, place it downwards, then mark out what? 1 inch. I normally use 1 inch for what? Females. Why for male? I use 2 inches. Okay, so now you've gotten this particular point. Next thing you are going to do is to do what? Mark out what we call what? Neck width, standard neck width. This standard neck width is not actually the neck width you are going to use, but I call it standard because I normally use it to do what? Slant my shoulder. Okay, the standard neck width in this case is going to be what? 3 inches. Please always make use of 3 inches for your what? Standard neck width. Now we have this point and we have this point. What next are we going to do? We are going to take our rule and do what? Connect. This is how to do what? Slope your shoulder. And it will give you a perfect work. Okay, so next thing we are going to do is still on the same topic to do what? We are going to draft the armhole. So in order for you to draft the armhole, please, we have these two methods of drafting the armhole. The first method is my own method, which I think is the simplest. Now, what is this method? This method is whatever you have as your shoulder. In this case, our shoulder is what? 14 inches. Divided by 2, you are going to get what? 7. So use the same thing as your what? Armhole length. Please always note that after coupling your clothes, you must also do what? Retrim the armhole, because after you must have coupled your clothes, the armhole length should have what? Reduced. Do you understand? Okay, so look at it. Whatever you have at the shoulder, shoulder is what? 14 divided by 2, which is what? 7, and I added extra half inch to it, making it what? 7 and a half. Now, in this case, since your shoulder is 14 divided by 2, which is 7, please take down the exactly the same 7. Make sure you don't add the allowance you have on your what shoulder. Okay, look at it. I have what 7. At this particular point is where you are going to mark out what we call the what armhole base. Now, look at it. In order for you to construct armhole, we have what we call the what armhole length. Are you seeing it? So, I've told you guys how to get the armhole length. Whatever you have, your shoulder, if your shoulder is 14 divided by 2 is what 7, is the same thing you use as your what armhole length. Then for the armhole base, are you seeing it? Just draw a line like this. Are you seeing it? Just draw a line. So now the question is, where is the armhole base going to stop? Are we drawing this line till when? Where are we going to stop? Look at it. It's wherever your bust stops, that's where the what armhole base stops. Are you seeing it? I see sometimes some people normally do something like this around the what armhole. This is very, very wrong. Please, wherever your what bust line stops, are you seeing it? That's where this one stops. So assuming you the allowance you add, as you can see, the allowance we added on this one is what 2 inches. Now assuming the allowance is up to what 3 inches, that means the armhole depth, the armhole base is stopping at this very point also. Okay, so now we've constructed the what our armhole length and our armhole base. What next are you going to do? We are going to curve add what we call the what the armhole curve. Now, how do you get this armhole curve? We get this armhole curve by making use of what we call the what. This is the simplest method. Are you seeing it? At this angle, whereby the vertical and horizontal line joined, make sure you place your tape like this diagonally and mark out what 1 inch. This I normally use this in whenever I want to do what mark out a curve. Are you seeing it? So next thing you are going to do is what from here, from the middle part of the armhole, make sure you connect going through the what 1 inch. As you can see, I've gotten my what armhole curve. So next thing I'm going to do is to do what effect what we call armhole effect. Then what is this armhole effect? Armhole effect is an effect we normally do on a cloth so as to make sure that the armhole region whenever you wear your clothes is lapping and relaxing very well. Sometimes you notice people wearing clothes, whenever you look at their armhole region, you notice that it's too rumpled, it's too folding. So in order to avoid that, you put what we call armhole effect around the word armhole. So how do we do this armhole effect? Now look at it. This armhole effect is applied by, look at it, whatever you have as your armhole length divided by 2, which you are going to get to what 3.5. Then on this 3.5, please make sure you place your tape. Now go backwards with what 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch. But for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'll be making use of what 1/2 inch. So now you've gotten this point, you've gotten this point, and you've gotten this point. What next are you going to do is to do what? Connect like this. Okay, so now I want to let you know something. This armhole effect is only applied in front, it is not applied at the back, because while looking at the front part, you notice that the armhole part of the front is what going inside while the back is coming outside. So that's why we apply it only what in front. So whenever you are cutting this particular armhole, please always make sure that first of all you cut out starting from the what the original part. Are you seeing it? So when you have finished cutting your front and back, that is when you not do what cut out the what shape of the front. Always know that armhole effect is only added in front of the clothes. Okay, so now we are done with the armhole. What next are we going to do? Now let's go move over towards neck construction. Now how do you construct neck? We construct neck making use of what we call what neck block. So how do you get neck block? We get neck block using our what neck width and our what neck depth. Okay, so neck width we are going to use in this case is going to be 5 inches. So how do you know your neck width? Please, I would always like you to know that your neck width is on your own discretion. Whatever you want your neck width to be, that is what it's going to be. What do I also mean by neck width? Neck width is how wide the neck of your dress is. Do you understand? So in this case, I'll be making use of what? 5 inches. Are you seeing it? So when you get this 5 inches, next thing you are going to do is to do what? Take your rule and do what? Draw out a straight line. Please remember, we are still on the verge of forming what we call the what? Mid-neck block in order to construct our neck. Okay. So next thing we are going to do is to do what? Mark out our neck depth. Please, neck depth also is on your own discretion. Whatever you want your neck depth to be, that's what it's going to be. So if you want it to go down so as for people to see your cleavage, make sure you use what? Use around 7, 8 to 9 inches. But for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'll be making use of what? I'll be making use of 4 inches. So at this point, take your rule and do what? Mark out a straight line. So as you can see, we've actually formed the what? The neck block. So what next are we going to do? Next thing we are going to do is to do what? curve out the word neck. Always remember that the neck curve is usually like this. Are you saying it? But I cannot just do it like this because I still have a particular formula or method which I normally use. Okay, now look at this method. This method is the same method I actually used here. Are you saying it? I used the word 1 inch. Please, this is only done whenever you want to get a what? A round neck. There's what I call a round neck, and there's also what I call a canoe neck. Okay, whenever you want to get a round neck, look at it. Mark out 1 inch diagonally. As you can see, the same thing we did at the armhole. Then you do what? You connect. So at the end of the day, we've gotten this particular white round neck. Do you understand? It's not a normal, it's a white round neck, looking as a canoe neck, but not exactly as a canoe neck. So for you to get that canoe neck, which is what? Getting that canoe shape on the neck. All you are going to do is what? Instead of using 1 inch like this, you are going to diagonally mark out what? 2 inches. Look at it. When you diagonally mark out 2 inches, so in that case, we are going to connect our neck like this. So this gives you the canoe kind of shape on the neck, and this gives you the what? The canoe neck. Okay. So next thing, as you can see, we are done with the neck. Okay. So obviously you know how to cut the back neck. The back neck, you can either use exactly what you use in front, or do what? Make it higher or lower. Okay. Please, I always want you to know something. I always want you to know about neck is that neck, when I say the width and the depth is at your own discretion, does not mean you just abuse it. What am I saying? Please always know that the neck shape supposed to be what? Proportional. The wider you go, now let's say for example you use a neck width of what? 3 inches. And you at the end of the day say you want to use a neck depth of what? 8 inches. Now looking at it, 3 inches and 8 inches. Now we now get the what? The round neck. Can you see that it's looking so awkward? So that means you cannot just use exactly whatever you want. You understand? But what I mean by using on your own discretion is when you know what you are using is what? Proportional to each other. As you can see, this neck width is proportional to this neck depth. So what am I trying to say? The wider you go, the down, more down you go. Are you seeing it? The wider you go, the more down you go. Okay. Why? The narrower you come, the upper you come. Okay. So that is it. So that is it for the neck. So next thing I'm going to teach us now is to how to construct a sleeve, a proper sleeve. But before we move into that, please, I want you to know something. Always know that, remember the formula that I gave you on how to do what? Get your what? Armhole. This is the simplest formula ever. But we also have another formula which we use. If you like, you can compare two of them together. We use it to get our what? Armhole length. Remember, armhole length is distance from this damn part of the shoulder. Are you seeing it? To the what? Armpit. That is the armhole length. Which I told you that the formula we used in getting this one is whatever you have on your shoulder. If your shoulder is 14, divided by 2 is what? 7. So that means you also use what? 7. But another formula you can also use is to do what? Divide your bust. In this case, this bust is what? 34 inches. Now divide it by 6 inches. When you divide it by 6 inches, you now add allowance of what? 1.5. Now when you divide 34 by 6 plus 1.5, what you'll be getting is around 7.1. Can you see that it is almost the same thing as what? 7 inches. So this shows you that this formula is also in correspondence to what? My method. Thank you very much. So like I said, I'll be teaching you guys how to properly cut a sleeve. Hello guys, and welcome back to C Fashion Academy. I will now be talking on the word sleeve, how to draft a perfect sleeve. Okay, so please, I want us to know something. Before you draft a perfect sleeve, always know that you draft the sleeve specifically to a particular cloth. For me, people usually think that drafting a sleeve, you can draft what we call general sleeve, which when you fix it on a cloth, it will balance. Yeah, so many people do try that. But please, I would like to tell you that whenever you are drafting a sleeve, please make sure you draft it for that particular garment or for that particular dress you're actually making. What am I trying to say? Looking at these bodies now, as you can see, the upper bodies, I'm going to draft the sleeve specifically made for this what? Armhole. As you can see. So for you to draft a sleeve, first thing you need to do is to do what? You need to fold your fabric for the what? The sleeve. So in order for you to fold your fabric, I have this formula. Let me teach you guys how to fold the fabric so as for you not to what? Waste your fabric or fold lesser than what you're supposed to fold. Okay, for you to fold your fabric, please, we'll be working with the what? The armhole length. Now this is the armhole length. From here to here is the armhole length. Are you seeing it? Okay, so the armhole length from here to here is what? 7 inches. Okay, so now 7 inches, add extra 2 inches to it. That 2 inches, I want you all to know that the 2 inches is what? Constant, making it what? 9 inches. So that means you are going to fold what, 9 inches. Now, in a case whereby you fold more than 9 inches, this I always want to let you know that it is still okay. All I'm trying to say is that you should not fold anything less than what, 9 inches. Now look at it. As you can see, I folded something more than what, 9 inches, so which is also okay. So next thing we are going to do after you are done folding is to do what, now start marking out, drafting the what, the sleeve. Okay, in order for you to draft the sleeve, remember I said we'll be working with the what, the armhole length. Okay, from here mark out the armhole length, which is what, 7 inches. Are you seeing it? When you mark out the armhole length, which is what, 7 inches, add that extra 2 inches to it. These 2 inches is what I call the what, the sleeve allowance. It is constant, can use it for any size. Do you understand? Okay, so after you are done doing that, next thing you are going to do is to do what, mark out what we call the what, the armhole base. Now which one is the armhole base? Remember initially I told us that the armhole base is distance from here to here. Are you seeing it? The distance from here to here. So all you need to do is to do what, take your tape and measure what you have. As you can see, what I have here is what, 3 inches. So if it is 3 inches at this particular point, are you seeing it? At this particular point, place your tape and mark out what, 3 inches. Okay, now place your tape and mark out what, 3 inches. Look at the point. So after you finish marking it out, next thing you are going to do is to do what, you are supposed to do what, cut for the what, sleeve. This is normally how we cut for the sleeve, but I cannot teach you guys this way because I want to teach it in full details. Okay, so in order to really give you the full details, after you are done marking out the what, armhole base, next thing you are going to do is to do what, get the midpoint from the original measurement. Are you seeing from here to here, which is what, 7 inches? Get the midpoint, which is going to give you what, 3.5. So at this point, you have to step back with what, 1/2 inch. You have to step back with what, 1/2 inch. So in this case, you have this point, have this point. So all you need to do is to do what, connect both together. Are you seeing it? Connect both of them. So after you finish connecting both of them, then gradually slide to the what, the middle part around this region. Are you seeing it? So now we are done with this. Now look at it again, connect it like this. Okay, then after you are done, next thing you are going to do is to do what, you are going to mark out your what, sleeve length. Sleeve length in this case is what, 8 inches. Now mark it out. Are you seeing it? When you mark it out, take your ruler and what, draw it straight. Okay, so after you finish drawing it, next thing you are going to do is to do what, impute your what, round sleeve on that particular point. So in this case, the round sleeve is what, 12 inches. So 12 inches, which is what, divided by 2, is going to give you 6 inches. So mark out the 6 inches. Now add extra 1.5 to 2 inches, but for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'll be using what, 1.5. Are you seeing it? So next thing you need to do is to do what, connect it from here to here. So this is the simplest way on how to draft a particular sleeve. Are you seeing it? I use exactly what I have here to draft this sleeve, so that at the end of the day, when you take this sleeve to fix on this particular dress, is going to fit properly. Okay, so as you can see, I'm done. So next thing I really want you to know is that some persons will not be like, what I usually see some persons put something they call what, bicep. This is what, bicep measurement. Yes, obviously you can also use bicep measurement to construct your sleeve. So how do you do this? Please, I want you to know that a bicep is immediately after the armhole. When you measure the upper arm, that is actually the what, the bicep. So in order for you to do it, is I want you to use this, my standard and sharp method, in order to do it. From here, measure out what, 5 inches. I normally use 5 inches as my what, standard bicep length. Okay, so let's say the bicep of this particular cloth is 13. So at this point, measure out what, 6.5. Are you seeing it? When you measure out 6.5, now I want you to also do a measure out what, 1.5. So as you can see, the bicep is still within the what, the original measurement. So that is to tell you that, so provided that your what, armhole length is correct and your what, round sleeve is correct, your bicep is always going to fall in the right place. Okay, so that is it. So next thing you're also going to do is to do what, you make sure you take your scissors and they cut it off. Okay. Okay, as you can see, after you are done cutting it off, next thing you need to do is to do what? Take your scissors and notch at the center. It is always very, very important. So now look at the final thing I'm going to do. Most people don't know that. Remember I told you that you apply the armhole effect in front of every dress. This is also applicable to the word the sleeve. You don't only apply the armhole effect on the dress and leave the sleeve, you also apply it on the sleeve. Most of us don't really know about this. This really helps your clothes to really what, relax very well at the what, armhole region. Okay, so now look at it. For you to really apply, remember the armhole effect is what? From here, you stepped in by what, half inch. Please also do the same thing at the midpoint of this particular armhole. Look at it. From here, step in by what? Half inch. Are you seeing it? So next thing you're going to do is what? From this particular point, are you seeing it? From this notch point, connect. Then as you be going, make sure you don't go below. Make sure you still land at the same what? The same particular length. Are you seeing it? So next thing you're going to do is to do what? Take your scissors and cut it up. Please, always know that. Please, don't never you make mistake. As you can see, this particular sleeve is for this particular side of the what? Body. Are you seeing it? Please don't take the sleeve for the left and go and fix on the right. As you can see, the dart, which is the what, the armhole effect of the sleeve, is also facing the armhole effect of the front. So this is it. So next thing you're going to do is to cut it off. So how do you cut it off? Open it wide like this. As you can see, take your scissors and do what? Cut it out. So after you finish cutting it off, please make sure you take your what? Make sure you take your chalk and mark it out, so as when you are fixing it, you will not make mistake. So look at it now. Are you seeing it? The armhole effect on the body versus what? The armhole effect on the sleeve. So this is actually how to what? Make your what? Sleeve perfectly using your what? Dress. Thank you very much and may God bless you.
So guys, thanks for watching. Please, I want you to make sure you click on that like button. Make sure you click on that like button. Click on that thumbs up so as to make sure you keep receiving our new videos. Thank you and may God bless you. So if you are new to this channel, I want you to make sure you click on that subscribe button. If you are old in this channel too and you've not subscribed, please make sure you do so by clicking on that red subscribe button. Also make sure you click on that notification bell so as to make sure you receive our new videos immediately we post it. Thank you and may God bless you. Please, if you actually skipped this video, please make sure you go back and watch this video because there are many secrets to be unveiled if you have not really watched them. Thank you and may God bless you.